Okay, so I was talking about example 5.5. So in this example, if you see xl is same and fxl is also same, xu is same and fxu is same, and then xr is calculated by using the different expression, and that expression I have already shown you before. So this is fxr, and then what we did, we multiplied fxl with the fxr, and this answer is negative. So it means xl is equal to xl for the next trial, and xu is equal to xr. So for example, in the next trial, if you see here, the xl is actually equal to xl, and xu is equal to now xr, and the same thing should be here. Yeah, here if you see, xl is 12 and xu is now 14.9, which is actually the previous value of xr. And then if once we simplify this new fxu value, so we will get new value of xr, and this new value of xr would be 14.793, and here it is, you can say that it is 14.794. it's very close to this value, and so on. So in this case, the approximate error is 0.79%, and if we go for the third and fourth trial, our approximate error has been further reduced. So this is the all about this method and this chapter. So I have given you the core of this this chapter, and the whatever is left, I think by reading the text and by going through the content itself, you can understand and you can make it clear to yourself. And if you face any problem, you're welcome. You can leave your comment, you can give me an email, you can give me a call. So have a good day, and thank you, and bye bye.